Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to explain nested loops in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Hey, all you people. Let's talk about nested loops. A nested loop is a general concept of having one loop inside of another loop. And that's really it. It doesn't matter if it's a for loop or a while loop. So, the inner loop will finish all of its iterations before we finish one iteration of the outer loop. And to best demonstrate this, we're going to create a program where we will draw a rectangle made out of a certain symbol that we choose. We need to set a width and a height. And to best do this, we'll need to use a nested loop. We'll create a few prompts, one for rows, columns, and a symbol that we want to make a rectangle of. So let's begin with rows. Rows equals input. How many rows? And we'll need to cast this as an integer data type because we're working with numbers. Okay, let's do the same thing for columns. So replace rows with columns for this next line. Input, how many columns? And we'll create a symbol variable. Symbol equals input, and this we don't have to cast. Enter a symbol to use. Now it's time for the nested loops. We're going to create an outer for loop as well as an inner for loop. The outer for loop will be in charge of the rows. The inner for loop will be in charge of the columns. So let's begin by creating our outer loop. So we'll write for I in range rows. We would like our outer for loop to iterate as many times as we have rows. And we're going to create an inner for loop that will iterate as many times as we have columns. So within the block of code for the outer for loop, we're going to create another for loop. This time it'll be for, and a common convention for inner loops is to write j as an index because j comes after I guess. So for j in range columns. So our inner for loop will iterate for as many times as we have columns. All we'll do within the inner for loop is print our symbol that we have, except we'll have one issue. Using a print statement, after we use the print statement, we will enter a new line character in and move down to the next line. We can actually prevent that by adding comma end equals quotes. So after using a print statement, this will prevent our cursor from moving down to the next line. So pay attention to the indentation too. So there's kind of two levels of indentation. We're currently within the inner for loop. So that's pretty much it for the inner for loop. Now we're going to print a new line once we exit the inner for loop. And you can see that the indentation is on this line right here. We're within the outer for loop now. And that's pretty much it. So let's try this program. How many rows? Let's say 5 rows. How many columns? Perhaps 6. What symbol do we want to use? Let's say the dollar sign. And let's try it. There we go. There's our rectangle. So we have, let's see, 6 columns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 5 rows. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In summary, a nested loop is really just this concept of having one loop inside of another loop. It doesn't matter if it's a while loop or a for loop. It's really situational. The inner loop will finish all of its iterations before finishing one iteration of the outer loop. So what we did to demonstrate that is that we had the outer loop in charge of the rows and an inner loop in charge of the columns for our rectangle program. So if you would like a copy of this program, I will post this in the comment section down below. But yeah, that's the basics of nested loops in Python. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learned something new, then help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.